why the store was closed for 3 days.
Only worker here.
Only worker.
Doing this with no shelves, no nothing. Look at this.
She's the only worker here.
Where are we? This side right here.
Look at this, guys.
All of that.
It's trash.
She left them to stock this whole store by herself.
She left them
to... No bathroom breaks.
No breaks. She's, like, not even supposed to be working right now, but she's been the only reason why they're open. She says she stopped working for 3 days, and that's why the store was closed for 3 days. Left them to stock all this. Everything, guys. These people don't even work here and they're helping her. Look at this. Walls of boxes. All by herself.
That is at a Dollar Tree in Austin, Texas, where a single manager was left alone to run a store by herself. And as you can see, customers were there helping her, which is a nice change of pace instead of taking things. Which might have been, I'm like, might have, and would I be that good? I don't know. That's pretty great. But the point is, let's focus on the real enemy, which is obviously the CEOs and the overall managers of these stores and these giant franchises. Again, 2 years after COVID-19 pandemic, and workers are still being hung out to dry like this woman was. And they're making hand over fist money. So let's get into, you know, what's been going on in terms of the workers' front, because it's not over. The fight is not over. But important to know that workers at billion-dollar companies like Dollar General and McDonald's make on average less than $15 an hour while often being forced to work in unsafe, grueling conditions. And in that case that you just saw there, she was severely understaffed, which apparently is a habit of Dollar Tree in order to avoid having to pay more wages. Just understaff it, works out for everyone, right? Don't you love when you go somewhere and there's no one to help you and no one to stock the shelves, to say nothing of what it must be like to work there? But Dollar General store workers are actually doing something about it. So over in Marion, North Carolina, workers walked off their job. And this is from Ashley Sierra, who worked at Dollar General for 2 years, makes just $11 an hour while only receiving part-time hours, which is just insane. She's a mother of three. She relies on family members to barely make ends meet and says, "My weekly paycheck is no more than $200, $260 at the max. I have three children. I cannot survive on $260 a week. It's just not working. It needs to get upped to at least $15 an hour. The bottom is $15. Because we worked so hard for so little," said Sierra. How's the CEO doing? Just, you know, if you guys are wondering if like they're making out okay. Dollar General reported a profit of $3.2 billion and their CEO was paid over $16.4 million in a single year in 2021, 986 times the median pay of the company's workers. Dollar General, y'all. Like, they're already, their business model is already making them tons of money in terms of the stuff that they're probably paying a few cents to the dollar on whatever is being sold there. But I was just floored by that video. Anna, I want to kick it over to you.
I wasn't floored by that video, because that is the scene you're likely to see in so many different workplaces across the country right now. It's not rare to maybe meet with some friends for dinner and notice that there's a single server waiting an insane amount of tables. Like, no human can handle all that work on their own. But that is not a bug of the system. It is the feature of this system. Mm-hmm. Because the reason the CEOs, the executives, the shareholders are able to walk away with so much money, such a huge return on their investment in the case of shareholders, and also such huge payouts and you know, bonuses and all of that by the executives, is because they find ways to cut costs to maximize profits. And the only thing that helps to mitigate that damage is when you have an organized workforce. And so whenever I have these moments of despair, which to be quite honest with you is almost every day now, and I want to give up because I'm like, what's the point of doing this anymore? Like I'm going through, like I'm putting my mental health through a lot just to do my job. I can't stand it and it feels like we're not making any progress. The one thing that keeps me hanging on is organizing workers, striking workers, workers in places like Starbucks stores across the country that have managed to unionize and are currently undergoing efforts to unionize. Mm-hmm. An Amazon facility unionizing in Staten Island. Like these are things that make me think, okay, there are people who are looking for ways to make their environment better for themselves, yes, for their colleagues. And they're doing it by circumventing our elected lawmakers who have done nothing for us in recent years. I would say in some cases, recent decades.
Absolutely. I just want to jump in because there's a new front opening in this workers' fight. And it's one that had been open for a while when it comes to the fight for 15 among fast food workers. But as you heard with the manager at Dollar General, 15 is the minimum we will start at. And over here in so-called progressive California, workers at McDonald's are walking off the job. So in Los Angeles on Monday, May 2nd, they began a strike. Because the place smelled like crap. It was disgusting and they didn't want to work there anymore. This is according to one worker who says, it gives me headaches, stomach aches, nausea. It's been happening to my coworkers, said Yasmina Alfaro, one of the striking workers at the McDonald's location. It's become a horrible smell all over the kitchen and store and we've noticed there's water leaking with disgusting debris. Yeah. She explained the past year, a foul odor has been emanating from the pipes near the drive-through window, but severely worsened over the past week through the entire restaurant. Despite the odor, workers were still expected to conduct business as usual. Alfaro said she had missed days of work due to getting sick from the odor and had not been compensated for that time of missed work. Okay, but to be fair, maybe the CEOs are kind of strapped right now and like they don't have the money to fix the piping. Let's check in on how their revenue is going. Oh, $23 billion in 2021, which was a 59% increase from 1 year earlier. That's incredible. Wow. So I guess they got money to give them a days off they want, fix the pipe, and maybe give them a raise while they're at it. Anyway, that's so, and just to give you a sense, people are rising up, especially in retail and in fast food work. As Anna was saying, this is the last graphic. The Bureau of Labor Statistics reported that more people had quit their jobs in November 2021 than any months since it started keeping track in the year 2000. And every month since, at least 6% of accommodation and food service workers have left their job more than any other sector. And in tandem with the ones who are staying around, fast food and retail are the fastest growing unionizing workforce. The most applications for NLRB status for a recognized union is coming from those same exact sectors. So as Anna said, there's reason to be hopeful.
For more political news breakdowns, interviews, stories of activism, and me trying my hardest to care about the occasional big celebrity news story, subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/thedamagereport. And you can ring the bell wherever it is so you don't miss anything.